And of course, we need increased focus on preventing heart failure in the first place. So it's phenomenal to have the advances we have for the sickest patients with advanced heart failure, and we need to apply those therapies that can truly be life-saving, which is great, but our broader approach towards really benefiting the population health of those with heart failure by applying our guideline-recommended therapies is so critically important and should be a major focus of anybody with an interest in heart failure. So prevention of heart failure is certainly critical. Behavioral lifestyle plays an important role there. Behavioral change among the most difficult things to achieve, but we have some things that can readily be done. Hypertension, major risk factor for developing heart failure at every age. So more aggressive, appropriate, intensive management of systolic blood pressure can play a phenomenal role. Atherosclerotic cardiovascular disease plays a major role. There's still underutilization of statin therapy and high intensity statin therapy for those with atherosclerotic cardiovascular disease, as well as those at risk. Despite widely available, well-tolerated, and benefits that greatly outweigh the risks, and being available generically for $40 a year. We also recognize that, in fact, you know, regular physical exercise can be important. So building healthier cities, completely agree with. Diabetes, major risk factor for heart failure. There's now a remarkable therapy that not just lowers hemoglobin A1C, better glucose control, but actually dramatically lowers the risk of heart failure. But most endocrinologists don't use the therapy. Most patients with diabetes are not yet on this therapy, even though it distinguishes itself from other diabetes medications in that this one can truly prevent heart failure, the sodium glucose cotransporter 2 inhibitors. So there have been a number of therapeutic advances in prevention of heart failure, but getting that translated for population health benefits is a critical challenge that really I think everybody that's involved in the care of heart failure should be involved with, because they see the consequences, a real concerted effort to try and prevent heart failure.